glad we are in the house of the Lord today.
Hallelujah.
We want to see Jesus lifted high. Let's rejoice in the presence of God. Good all the time. Thank you, Lord. God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good, yes, all the time. Through the darkest night, His light will shine. God is good. Amen. God is good all the time. God is good. Hallelujah. He put a song of praise in His heart of mine. God is good. Thank you, Lord, all the time. In the darkest night,
Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you for your presence this morning. Hallelujah. We bless you. We honor you, Lord. And through it all, every season of our lives, you are there for us, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
For the
Glorified in this church, Lord.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord. Let's give a hand clap offering to the Lord. Be glorified, God.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Be glorified, Lord, in everything that we will do today. Hallelujah. Praise God. You may be seated. And we would like to welcome everyone to our Sunday celebration and also our Mother's Day celebration for all for the blessing Geneva. And we would like to welcome everyone here. We would like, of course, to welcome our first visitor, Sister Jean Rose. Sister Jean Rose. Okay. The children of Sister Mandy and Sister Annabelle. Praise God. Welcome. God bless you. Praise God. And we're glad to have you with us. Any other first-timers? First-timers? All-timers? And of course, we welcome Sister Regina. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. And we're glad to have everyone with us. So shall we all stand up and let's welcome one another with the love of the Lord. So tell them, God bless you. God has a wonderful plan for you. Amen. Hallelujah. Teaching, but we will resume it next Sunday. So after the service, Sister Regina will be praying for the mothers, and since Mother's Day, and in the meantime, we will be taking our tithes and our offerings, our mission offering, and then while we are taking the mission offering, we will be flashing our announcements. Praise God. So I'd like to call the ushers to come forward. Praise God. This week there was a mission to Poland, and then it's also this week that there's a mission in Russia, or is it next week?
That's next week.
So next week will be the mission to Russia, and this month also we will have a mission to Indonesia. And as you know, the Blessing Geneva is supporting, is sending mission support. So let's remember that if you cannot go, we are sending people there, that the message can be preached and souls can be saved. And for every soul that is won to the Lord, we partake in that victory. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you, God, for the privilege that you have given us to give unto to be partakers, Lord God, of the mission work, Lord God, to give unto you, Lord God, to be able to send workers into those places, Lord, where people have not heard about the love of God. Father, we pray that you will bless us, Lord, as we give. And we know, Lord, that you will provide for our needs. You will open the windows of heaven and pour out your blessing and meet every need, whether it be a need for healing, Lord. We remember, Lord God, the father of Brother Lamy. We pray that you will bless him. We pray that you will raise him up, wake him up from his comatose in the name of Jesus. We know that you are a miracle-working God. And Lord, if there is anyone else who is sick in our midst, Lord, Father, we pray that you will touch them and heal them, Lord. And Lord, for those who are in need of jobs, Lord, for blessings, Lord, for financial breakthrough, we pray, Lord God, that you will provide. You will show yourself as the Jehovah Jireh, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Bless, Lord God, and provide and heal, encourage us and lift us up, O God. We thank you, God. We give you the glory and the honor in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So just like what we saw on the announcement, but I mentioned earlier that we will have no Bible study this afternoon. But next Sunday we will continue. We will resume our study. Last two Sundays we had a video study on the resurrection. Why we believe in the resurrection and why? What is the impact? What is the importance of the resurrection on our lives? And one of the things that the speaker mentioned is. The proof that the resurrection is real is how God has changed his life and how God has changed many lives here in the Blessing Geneva. If I were to look at many of the people here, I can see that God is alive because of what he has done in each of us. Praise the Lord. And we believe that the hand of God is upon us. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Are we ready to receive the word? Oh, sorry. Sorry, we have a birthday celebrant, sorry. And we would like to call Kyla to come forward. And because it's her birthday. Anyone else who's celebrating their birthdays? Anyone else? Anyone else? Okay, so we have Kyla. And we will sing happy birthday. Provided for her and the family. Thank you, God. And we thank you, Lord God, because we know, Lord, that you will bless her even more this year as she grows up, Lord God, in you, Lord God, that she will find favor in the eyes of God, in the eyes of men, Lord, that your hand will be upon her, that you will use her as a channel of blessing to her family, Lord, to her classmates, Lord God, even to the church, Lord. We know, Lord God, that you have something wonderful for this child, Lord God. Bless her. We commit her to you, God. And we know, because we know that in your hands is the safest place that she could ever be. We thank you, God. We give you the glory, the honor, and the praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Happy birthday.
So after the service, like I said, Sister Regina will be praying for the mothers, and we will have food fellowship. Praise God. Are we ready to receive the word?
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. So let's put our hands together and let's give a warm welcome to Sister Regina Maasbach.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
How are you?
Good.
I missed you. Oh, okay. Thank you. Happy Mother's Day. It was a big surprise for me when Pastor David asked me, can you go on Mother's Day to the Blessing Geneva? And then I said, okay, what about The Hague, Holland, our church in The Hague? He said, no, it's okay, you can go there. I think we would love to have you there. I'm fine, I go there. I love to go there. So, but Pastor David brings his greetings to you and all the workers and all the brothers and sisters from all the churches. They always pray for you like you do for them. I know that. And this morning, but my children are not here, but I feel it's really Mother's Day. They texted me and that was enough for me because I can be with you. This last month, we have a magazine in Holland called New Life. You know that magazine?
Yes.
Yeah. And this time I had an article in there for the moms. And when I heard that I was going to Geneva, I asked the girls to translate it in English and have the article on paper. So it's in English, it's for the moms who want it. Afterwards, it's in the back, so you can get one. And then you can read the article.
Okay.
Oops. Oh, okay. So, today it's Mother's Day, and of course, I want to especially encourage all the moms, all the mothers, by saying to you, moms, you are unique.
Amen.
You are special. And you are special because you have brought one or more children in the world. And that's why you are special. Let's pray together. Lord, thank you that we can be here together with everybody, but especially the moms. Thank you, Lord, that you will bless all of us. Thank you for your word in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Did you bring your Bible?
Yes.
Okay, good, good. So, you are special. Don't forget that. And I think that all the moms, they love their children with the whole heart. Can I hear amen?
Amen.
Yeah. And if you love God, you will do everything, you want to do everything that is necessary to raise your children in the fear of the Lord. That's what I have. That's what I want. And I think that's what you want too. And although I'm active in the ministry and in the church, I have my responsibilities, but I want to be helpful wherever I can be. And I'm also expressing my creativity in making bracelets and everything for the family bookstore. But besides that, I really enjoy being a wife for Pastor David and a mother for my children. And soon for my grandchild, for my grandboy. I think no matter how society changes around us, the highest calling for a woman is still the motherhood. And when you are entrusted with the life and care of a child, for me, that's one of the greatest responsibilities that you can have. And then to think that you may prepare nature and raise a life for eternity. What a privilege that is. So, you know, that in a few weeks, like I told you, Pastor David and I will be grandparents. In Holland, we say Opa and Oma. Can you say that? Opa,
Oma.
But it sounds, of course, old, because then I'm an Oma. And when you talk about an Oma, you think of a knot and gray hair. But I don't have... Yeah, I do have gray hair, but I... So Alyssa will have a baby boy. And, you know, because it's their first child, then I try to give Jonathan, that's her husband, and Alyssa, bits by pieces, little advices to prepare them what is coming. And we already have installed the spiritual principles in their children's life from the early age on. And I know Jonathan is also raised by his parents in these healthy spiritual principles. So therefore, I'm fully confident that our grandson will grow up in the same loving and obedient spirit as our children. And I know that Pastor David will tell all the Bible stories with fire and passion to the grandchild, because he also did that to our children when they were little. Yeah, you see this. This is one of the pictures that we took for the article for the magazine. So I thought I'll show it to you. We're all holding the baby. Jasmine, she cannot wait to be an aunt, and John Henry, he cannot wait to be an uncle. He wants to teach him how to play soccer, football. but the father, Jonathan, he is a hockey player. He loves hockey. Not John Henry said no, that cannot go together. So John Henry said, no, don't teach him to play hockey. That's for
cockers. That's rich people. Yeah.
We teach him to play soccer. Well, then Jonathan said, well, I don't know yet, but okay. But often people tell me that David and I and the children are a great blessing to them, and that because of that, David's busy activities, Pastor David's busy activities, the heavy burden of the upbringing for our children is mostly on my shoulders. Well, fortunately, the children are grown up now, they're adults now, but it was a great privilege for me to unburden Pastor David of that responsibility. So he could do the work that God has given us, through which millions of souls are all over the world been reached by the gospel of Jesus Christ. And our reward is that our children, they love the Lord, and they serve him, and they work with us together in the ministry. And this way, Pastor David and I are both sharing that reward. And it's a great blessing for me, for it shows me a good wife and a good mother is something important. And it gives satisfy and completion to your life. I love my work, I love my house, I love Pastor David, I love my children, and I do my best to do everything a wife, a mother is supposed to do. Our children, they are a blessing of God. And sometimes they have misbehaved, but with a good upbringing, with much love, patience, and with understanding, they cannot escape from the things they have learned from the young age on. And it was my task to help the children to develop good habits, and I did my very best to teach them the disciplines and the consistency. And I emphasized the importance of healthy food as well as the spiritual norms. After all, we are bodies of the temple of God. And this morning, it's hot in here, but that's okay. This morning, I want to encourage all the mothers because it's Mother's Day. But all of us came to church to receive. And that is why I want to say that what I'm about to share is important for all of us, not only for the moms, it's important for all of us. And it's my prayer that it will bring blessing to each of us, and that you will see the importance of it all, and that you will apply it and use it even more in your life. So let me begin with raising children, and then not about the normal daily things, but about the spiritual upbringing. I have one there. Thank you. And dear people, the mother and the father, but also the grandparents, they play a role in the faith of upbringing of the children and the grandchildren. And I told you that from an early age we installed spiritual values in our children. But even when they were babies, we sang with them, we sung with them, we prayed with them, we praised the Lord with them when we were holding them. But now they are grown up, they are adults, but it does not mean that we have completed the spiritual upbringing. Because it goes on, because the grandchildren are coming, and then we have a part in that too. And this is also for you in your life. You're a parent, or when you are a grandparent. You know, I believe that for a big part, the parents are surely responsible that their children will become believers of Christ. But of course, there's also a part in which the child has to accept Jesus, him or herself, as her personal savior. And this is a matter between them and God himself. It's the Holy Spirit that calls them by hearing the Bible stories in the children's church and at home, that they are told by the parents or the grandparents or other people, for example, at school, or the uncles and the aunts in the church. So we must read the Word of God to them, bring them also the Holy Spirit, which the Holy Spirit will bring other people around your children also to tell them about Jesus Christ. And therefore it's important that your child or your grandchild gets a clear picture of what faith means to us, and that we may for the rest we may leave it up to the Holy Spirit. So how can we show our children that our faith is important to us? How can we pass on our faith? So today I want to give you 9 building blocks of faith. We go through the 9 building blocks real fast. And these 9 building blocks, that you can use to be an example for the children. Because it's not only important that the children or the teenagers or the youth will see them in their parents, but also in us adults, especially when they are here in church. And not only on Sunday, but also in our daily life. It's confusing for a child when it sees us on Sunday like this, and when they see him through the week in a grocery store like that. So that's confusing for a child. So number one, maybe you want to write them down. Number one of the building block of faith is reading of the Bible. It's an unforgettable lesson for children when they see that parents, when grandchildren, parents, but also the people around them, show how important the Word of God for them is. It's important that the children will see that. And I hope that the Bible plays an important role in your life. And if that is so, then it's such a great example for them, because by seeing them, how important the Bible is for you, they will copy that. They will copy that. And it will help them when later on in life, how they can solve a problem by seeking advice in the Bible. And they saw that you did that, so they're gonna do that too. They copy that. So that's building block number one, reading the Bible. Number two is prayer. Teaching the children to pray when the parents and the grandparents pray together with them to God. And of course, you can teach them the Lord's Prayer. You know, you all know the Lord's Prayer in the Bible. Of course, you can learn the children that, but that's not enough. It's really all about praying together, talking to God with the heart. For example, at the house, when you sit at the table together with them, or when you're sitting on the couch, or kneeling together before the bed. And then you also have to teach them that they have to listen to God. So teach them it's important to pray, but also when they pray, when they talk to God, that they give God an opportunity to say something back in the quietness of the heart, so that, that you will take a few minutes with them to be quiet, so that the Lord can talk to them in the hearts. That's number two, prayer. Number three is obedience to God. It is one of the most important lessons that the children can learn, that their parents and their grandchildren act out of obedience to God. Not out of fear, but simply because God is our Heavenly Father and what we must be obedient. And children, they learn what it means to be obedient when they learn to obey the parents. So they have to obey the parents, not out of fear, but out of respect. And then they will also have respect and obedience to the Lord. Number four is forgiveness. One of the most important mandates in the life of a Christian is that we forgive. And forgive, dear brothers and sisters, is really much more than just to condone something. Forgiveness is this. We can read it in Ephesians number 4, verse 31. And it says there, let all bitterness, wrath, anger, clamor, and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. And be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God in Christ forgave you. So that is forgiveness. It's not just something, it's really something. Forgiveness, and we have to learn. We have to be an example in that for the children. Number five is living according to principles, not according to feelings. And remember, I'm still speaking about the spiritual upbringing. So feelings are not always reliable. We cannot always trust our feelings. And therefore, feelings must not dictate us what we must do. And it certainly must not keep us from doing what God is asking us to do. It's important that we show the children that we do things without our feelings telling so, but simply because we want to be obedient and obey God's principles. For example, if we go to church, if we go to the house of the Lord, you do not say, well, today we don't go, because I don't feel like it. Because then you teach them that they can only have to go when they feel like it. You know what I mean? And every time when they do not feel like it, when they don't feel to go to church, it will result in going less and less to church. And that's simply how it is. And when they take it easy in going to church, well, you know what will happen then. That was number five. Number six is showing them that you serve. When you show your children that you are willing to help a neighbor, or you are willing to help a brother or sister in the church, then they will follow you in that. They will follow that example. Helping others will not only bless you, but you will be also a great example for your children. So that is showing them to serve. Number seven, lead an orderly life. Take care of it that your house is always tidy. Try to eat together on set times. I know it's hard when they grow up, they have the after-school sports and everything. I know it's hard, but try to eat together on set times. Maybe it's not every day, but maybe 3 or 6 times a week. Try to do that. An orderly house is like a safety net. It's an extra security for the children. And the Holy Spirit can work in that order. Not in a chaos of emotional conflicts and family members that are only busy with themselves. Lead an orderly life. Building block number 8, that is, be encouraging. Do not accept your child to be perfect in everything. To always get high grades in school. It will be enough to see that your child has really done his very best. What it's all about is to be focused on the positive. And this concerns everything in general. It's always better to speak about the truth than the lie. And it's better to preach Christ than to preach against everything that is in a battle with him or her. The positive is always better than to contradict the negative. And that brings me to number 9. Number 9 is unconditional love. You can really, really, really show your children how God loves us by loving them in the same way. God loves us unconditionally. We don't have to earn his love. We cannot even earn his love. And even though God knows about our faults, he knows about all the mistakes and all our sins, he keeps loving us. And we can also love our children like this way, by making them clear to them that they do not have to earn our love. We just love them like the Father loves us unconditionally. So that were the 9 building blocks of faith. And maybe you say right now, well, Sister Regina, I really did all of this, but my children and my grandchildren, they still not come to church. They don't want to come anymore, maybe. They choose their own way, and, well, Jesus means nothing to them anymore. Well, if you really did everything that you needed to do, then it's not up to you. Then you can only do one thing, and that is, do not give up. Do not give up. Do never give up. So Mom, this is from my heart to your heart, all the moms. Believe that God will bring your children to the place where he wants them to be. Hold on to that faith. I know it's hard for us moms to give it over in God's hands and let him do it, but that's the only way it works. Keep praying and trust God. Not to fix and to manage and control the lives of our children, especially when they're bigger. Know that you have an identity in Christ. Have a strong vision for your children, moms. You know, some parents are so easily content if their children just go to church and they say, yeah, they love God. And they're so content with how it is rather than having a vision for their children, being on fire and fruitful in the kingdom, fulfilling the purpose of which they were born on this earth in whatever area God wants them to be. And of course, we all have to withstand the Dominic first, who wants to rob us and our children of God's plan. And many don't know how to fight, but really, Mom, you have to fight for it. Because if you do, you will see and you will feel the true faith and grace of God. So that was especially for you. So keep on praying and pleading for them. Keep loving them. The Bible says, love conquers everything. And the rest is a case of the Holy Spirit. Always remember that. It is still possible that one word that you speak or have spoken to them in, or a memory that comes up in them, it's still possible that this may do something in their life. Maybe when they're older, then this will bring them to other thoughts. We don't know which way the Lord will go with our children. But it may also be so that you as a parent, you just recently become a child of God, and your children were also already older. I know it's even harder then. Maybe you told them, maybe you told them a long time ago that there is somewhere up in the sky, way up in heaven, there is a man, and his name, they say, it's Jesus. And further, you haven't told them anything about it because you are not a Christian yourself. Well, then it's my prayer for you that one sentence that you gave maybe a long time ago will stir up in them and have a desire in your child to know more about God. And maybe you have never read the Bible with them, or you never prayed together with them, but maybe you did show them to forgive. Or you have always had a servant heart, and you reached out a helpful hand to other people. What I mean to say is this: little is needed, little is much in God's hand, because the Holy Spirit can make a wonderful big meal out of the little breadcrumbs we offer. A few words, a few moments that you gave as a good example can be enough for the Holy Spirit to bring somebody on the path of faith. And also, brothers and sisters, it is never too late. It is never too late. It's not too late for parents to show their children what faith means to them. It's not too late to start reading the Bible every day with them, even if you never done it before. It's not too late to pray with the children, even if they are like 15 or 16 years old. It's not too late to maybe start doing with your grandchildren what you haven't done with your own children. Because eventually, kids learn faith by our example. It was also Timothy who learned from a very young age to believe, from the example of his grandmother and his mom. So can we find in the Bible 2 Timothy 1 verses 5? And maybe Pastor Bon, can you read it with a loud voice?
2 Timothy 1, 5?
Yes, please. There are some difficult English words in there, so maybe you can read it for me.
When I call to remembrance the genuine faith that is in you, which dwelt first in your grandmother Lois and your mother Eunice, and I am persuaded is in you also.
Yes. The Lord uses fathers, he uses mothers, grandfathers, and grandmothers to install faith in the life of the children. And dear people, you are most effective when you live out of the Bible, of the biblical principles, when you are obedient to God's word. When you make this as your daily goal in your life, you are a great example. So, dear sisters and brothers, if I ask you this question, how would you answer this? Are you like the mother Eunice? Are you like the grandmother Lewis? Even through the whole Bible, we read only one sentence about them. But it is so important that we read this one sentence. Are you a grandfather or a grandmother like God has meant to be, has meant you to be, or a mom or a father. If you have to say no, well then remember, it's never too late. When we start to live according to the example of God's word, then without a doubt, it will bring blessings in the lives of others, but in the first place, in the lives of our children and our grandchildren. And then I hope that all of us, as a church, that we realize that we are partly responsible for the faith upbringing of the children in the congregation, in the church. And definitely also the ones who lead the kids' church during the service. We must lead and precede them by giving them the examples we just have heard, the faith building blocks. They are not only for the moms, not only for the dads, blah, blah, blah. It's for everyone. And you know, in the Young Maasbach World Mission, and in all the blessed churches, also in here, it's very important for us, the children's ministry. And we always invest a lot of time and a lot of energy in it. And myself too, for now, I think for the last 20 years, every year I lead the 6, 7, and 8-year-olds of our summer camp. And I love to tell them all the Bible stories and do fun things with them, but the important thing is to give them the faith building blocks, to be an example in that. The children must see in all of us that we love the Word of God, and then they will take over this love for God and for the Bible. So it's really good that we all have contact with the children, and I see you have, and that really bless my heart. So that I really love, but so especially on Sunday, we have to make contact with all the children and here in the church. And then I hope and I pray that they will see in us that we love the Lord and that we live according to His word, that they will see that what you say about the meetings and about the serving God, that they will see that those things are important for you. And if they see that those things are important for us, then they will think, hey, they are important for me too. We as a church, as a congregation, are partly responsible for the faith upbringing of the children. Let us never, never forget this. So always, always be careful what you say and what you do. So mommies, parents, remember always real good. We want our children to be successful. We want them to be happy. We want to give them everything what's important, but concerning faith, it's the most important upbringing that you absolutely cannot be weak about.
Amen.
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 Thank you so much. Praise God. Hallelujah. And so the message is not only for the mothers, but also for the fathers, for those who have children in their homes. These are the building blocks that we need to take note of. We have to ensure that those building blocks will be seen by the children at home. Because as the Word of God says, train up the child in a way that he should go, or he or she should go, and when they grow up, they will not depart from it. It is important to instill godly principles in the lives of children. Praise God. Hallelujah. So maybe let's change the program.
Yes.
We will call the mothers to come forward because we want to honor them since it is Mother's Day. So we will call all the mothers to come forward. So now it's my opportunity to see who are the mothers. Really. So that I will not make a mistake next year and I greet someone Mother's Day and they're not mothers. But yes, we will ask the mothers to come forward.
Yeah, you know what, Mother? was funny because they gave us a sticker, and then I thought, oh, then I know who are the moms. But then I saw everybody.
I lost my sticker. Anyway, yeah, so we ask all the mothers to come forward. Praise the Lord. Yes. I believe the church prepared something a little token of appreciation. Of course, I was reading on my Facebook early this morning. There was this post that says a dad's job is from morning until from sunrise until sunset, but the mother's job is never done. It's 24/7. So we would like to appreciate you, to say thank you for being here, for all the sacrifices. If it is not enough, we will take note and we will give you your those who don't have, we will get them next time. But we just want to show you that we appreciate everything, your sacrifices. And in fact, for many of you, you left your family because you want to support them. You left them in thousands of kilometers away, and you are making great sacrifices. Sometimes many sleepless nights. Sometimes you are taking care of children who are not your children. But God knows the sacrifices you made, and we want you to know that He loves you, and He has a wonderful plan for you and for your family. So God bless you. So shall we stretch up for the men and those who are, shall we stretch our hands towards the mothers and let's pray for them. Father, we thank you, God, for these mothers. We thank you, God, for their lives, for the sacrifices that they have made, for the sleepless nights, Lord God, for the nights, Lord God, when their children are sick and could not go to sleep, Lord God, for the many times that they have bended their knees in prayer for their children, for their families. Lord, even for those who are here who have left behind their families, their children, Lord, because they want to support them, Lord, by making sacrifice, we pray that you will continue to bless them, Lord God, that you will strengthen them, Lord, in times when they are discouraged, when they are lonely, when they are missing their families, Lord. We pray that you will be their comfort, you will be their strength, you will be their encouragement, Lord. That every day that they spend away from their families, Lord, you will be by their side, Lord, to continue to strengthen them. Bless them and bless them abundantly, Lord God. Thank you for the mothers. Thank you, Lord. And Father, we pray, O God, that you will give them the strength, Lord, that you will be first, and you will be first in their lives, Lord God, so that as they put you first in their lives, Lord God, you will give them the strength and the grace that they need so that they can lead and encourage their families as well. Thank you, God. We commit them to you, and we give you the glory and the honor in Jesus' name. Amen. Happy Mother's Day. God bless you. Praise God. And also,
Samson will take pictures.
Brother Samson will take pictures.
Can you catch them all together? Use the fish eye. Ay, oo nga po.
Stay mo lang ganyan. We'll flash the Happy Mother's Day greetings in the back.
Where's my wife?
Okay. Okay, so hold on, they're just changing the
the lens so that Brother Samson can take a wider pic, everyone can be included in the picture. Sister Regina will be praying for those mothers who are in need of special prayer. You can, Sister Regina will be here. She will pray for you. So, and then afterwards, you can have good fellowship. Praise God. So, let's just bow down our heads and pray. Father, we thank you, God, once again for the opportunity that we could give to you to support your work here in Geneva. Thank you, Lord God, that you have this is your church. You are the one who has established it. And Lord, you continue to bless us, Lord God, and use us so that more souls may come into your kingdom, so that we can continue, Lord God, preaching the word in obedience to your command. Bless us, Lord God, in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 While the offering is being taken, let me just read to you this this proverb, which is one of the most quoted proverbs during Mother's Day, Proverbs 31. But I like to focus particularly on verses 28 to 31. Her children rise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. Many daughters have done well, but you excel them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty is passing, but a woman who fears the Lord, she shall be praised. Amen. Give her the fruit of her hands and let her own works praise her in the gates. Yes, the word of the Bible says beauty is passing, but for me, every day that passes, my wife is getting more beautiful. Okay, you may accuse me of being biased, but I don't know. All right, please stand. So, shall we all stand up and let's pray? And then afterwards, Sister Regina will pray for the mothers, those who want special prayer. Praise God. We thank you, God, for your presence. We thank you for your word. We thank you that you have reminded us of these 9 building blocks that we need to make sure are present in our homes, Lord God, so that our children will grow in a loving environment, in an environment, Lord God, where they will see good examples, where they will see God moving in their lives of their parents, in the lives of the adults around them, Lord. May we, Lord God, be good examples to them. May, as the song says, may all who come behind us find us faithful, especially our children, Lord. May you use us, Lord God, to be a good example for them by your grace. We thank you, God. Hallelujah. And now may the love of God, our Heavenly Father, the grace of His Son, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and the communion, strength, and guidance of the Holy Spirit be with us. until He comes back. In the name of Jesus we pray. And everybody say, Amen. God bless you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. So for those who need prayer or who want to be prayed for by Sister Regina, you can come forward. And we will also have food fellowship on the other side. God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you.